Rev up your engines.
Dylan May, you says Scotty, are Chrysler Fiat cars made today good?
No.
No, they aren't. Oh, that's, they're probably the worst cars in the world that they sell in the United States at any route. I was reading the other day that Fiat was even thinking of pulling all their Fiats out of the American market. Now, of course, they own Chrysler, and they put a lot of their technology in the Chrysler cars. Like, if you buy a Dodge Dart, it's no longer the 60s Dodge Dart muscle car. It's all Fiat engine and transmission stuff. But they were thinking about pulling their cars out of the United States. The sales are so horrible because people would buy them and, yeah, they're horrible cars. They're not, you know? And they're always changing where they buy things from, you know? They were buying their transmissions. Some of them were made by Jatco. They're always trying to change stuff helter-skelter, and they don't seem to be very logical about what they do. I wouldn't buy them. Daniel Giraldo says, is it good to let my engine idle to reach operating temperature and then drive? No, you don't need to do that. Modern cars are computer-controlled. You don't want to idle your car long periods of time before you drive. The only reason you want to do something like that is you live up north, it's winter, the car's covered with snow and ice. Sure, start the car, let it warm up so you can get the ice off easier and it'll all melt and it'll be warm, and that's a good idea. But normally, no, you don't want to waste your time on stuff like that. Engineers tell me that actually it's bad for an engine to sit idle all that time, so. Colin Waglowski says, Scotty, I'm thinking about getting a 2015 Dodge Charger RT. Is it a fun, reliable car to get? Well, it is a fun car. There's no arguing that. You get one with a Hemi V8, they're screamers. They're fun to drive. V8s, they are fun to drive. Reliability, yeah, not so much as they age. They're a muscle car, and as they age, generally people drive them hard. Things tend to wear out. Being a Chrysler product, the electronics are kind of weak, so don't think that, you know, 15 years from now it's going to be a fun, reliable car. It probably won't be. But, you know, if you're going to buy a used one, at any rate, have a guy like me, a pro mechanic, check it out before you buy it. Because guys generally rag the heck out of them. You want a good mechanic to check it out before you buy it. The One Gamer says, Scotty, I saw a 94 Celica Black 5-speed manual with 80 to 85,000 miles and cost a little over $2,300. Should I jump on it? Well, yes, if that mileage is real. They're going to have proof. Because odds are a car that's 25 years old is going to have more than 80,000 miles on it. Now, I got a guy's lie. You can go to any junkyard and buy a dash, that thing for $60 if you can find one, pop it out, put that one in. It says it's got 80,000 miles. You want proof from oil change receipts, state inspections that show the real mileage. Because I had a customer buy a car like that once. I said, look at a Carfax. They did, and they saw that it really had like 190,000 miles a few years ago when it was inspected. And then all of a sudden later, it had a lot less mileage because they swapped the dash. So you'd want to make sure that's the real mileage and not a lot of baloney. You can't always believe what people tell you, even what it sees when they're that old. The logo guy says, looking for a good SUV crossover for my girlfriend. She's driving an 08 Toyota Yaris, which she says is small and doesn't feel safe. What's reliable and has a good safety thing? Okay, you want a good SUV crossover. I mean, you can't beat the Toyotas, but they cost an awful lot of money because they're so popular. That's the thing that I tell people. If you really have to have an SUV crossover, you're going to pay through the nose. That's just how it goes. You can't get out of that. Now, I tell people, hey, Toyota Camrys are real safe, reliable cars. Have a road test a Camry. Get a good used Camry. They can last a long time. You can get a halfway decent price on it. But SUVs, people just pay too much money because they're so popular, and it's sad but true. A lot of times you're better with a car. They're buying a crossover because you're going to just pay more money. They're popular. And as they're popular, they charge more money. That's how the world works. Scotty, what do you think about a CNG propane conversion for my 97 Toyota Celica 1.8 liter? Well, if done correctly and you go to natural gas or propane and want to run your car, they actually run cleaner. They get better fuel mileage, and the engines will actually last longer. But it has to be done correctly. And realize one thing. Generally, you're going to lose a lot of range because propane, CNG, it's pressurized in a tank. You can only get so much distance out of a tank of propane. You're going to get a lot more out of a tank of gasoline. Now, bigger vehicles like some of these city buses that have now, they've got huge tanks in them because they're big buses. There's lots of space, so it doesn't matter. And it's not a bad idea if you live in an area where the propane or CNG is cheap. I know a lot of people in Europe do that because it's so much cheaper. Or they're in an area where the only thing they have is natural gas and propane. They really don't have any gasoline or diesel. It's a good idea to do it then. But it has to be converted correctly so that it runs right. And you got to realize that you're not going to get the distance that you got before. You're going to have to keep filling those tanks up. Plus, you want to put them in a safe thing because if they ever get hit and blow, they're very flammable. Realize that.
So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.